I'd go for three, my top three. The first will be problem solving. I think that women are issue solvers and they are usually inspired by the challenges they go through. Women usually have quite a tough journey getting to the top. And so within that process, they build a lot of competence. They build depth, they understand the businesses they run. And so when they get to the positions of leadership, they are able to drive change. They are able to problem solve. They're able to look at the different perspectives and solve issues. And I think that's one great skill that women have at the top. The second for me is the ability to multitask. Listen, from the time this young girl is growing up to the time she starts to raise a family and take care of the home, there's a lot of concurrent issues that come up that the woman has to use that skill to solve. And so we carry that also into the workplace. And I think that as an effective leader, you will be presented with challenges and you would have to make decisions, you would have to get stuff done. And it's that skill, the ability to multitask, that I think helps women to be very, very effective at what they do. My third will be empathy. I think that if you want to grow with people, you have to learn how to work with them. You can't work with people when you don't understand them. You can't work with people when you don't take time to understand their emotions, because people go through a lot when they come to the workplace. And so I believe women carry this cognitive empathy to work. They are able to understand the emotions of people. They're able to encourage, able to support. And leadership is really about influence. You're able to influence people when you build relationships with them. And so when you bring empathy, that skill that you have to be able to understand how they feel, people give you more. And I think it's another strength, it's another skill that women have that helps them to lead and lead better. What I'll say to ladies in male-dominated industries, that you are unique. I think that you have a very privileged opportunity to open the doors for other women. So my first advice to you will be to keep going. Do not give up. If you do, other women will not find role models to be able to go through what you are going through today. So keep going. Women are 50% of the population of this country. We have tapped into the 50% of male. And I think we have a strong opportunity to grow the economy, to drive economic development when we tap into the remaining 50%. If you have started, you need to create the room for other women also to participate. So I encourage the woman to keep going. It can be very lonely. And so my second advice is to find professional networks. Follow other senior women on social media if you can find them. Join other women networks where you can get inspiration, where you can get support, find a coach, find a mentor, somebody you can talk to who will guide you along the way. Otherwise, you would feel you are alone and then you may give up, which would be quite a disappointment. We have done it and I think you can also do it.